Yeah. Good afternoon. Welcome. My name is Roland. That's all I will tell about myself. If you want to know more about me, I'm around. Welcome to the presentation on PHP Storm for developers. It will be in English. I speak German, but not good enough to do the presentation in German. But if you have any questions, just stop me and I can answer them. That's no problem. If you have any questions afterwards, it's also no problem. Welcome. So let's just start PHP Storm. It's one of the tools I started using quite a few years ago, because before I started with something called JEdit, which I think still around, but I don't know whoever still uses it. But it's actually an editor for Java, but I had a PHP plugin and it's free. So for starting developer, that was a great tool. But then the development of the PHP plugin in that editor kind of stopped. So I switched over to Eclipse, another free tool. So I like that as well. There the same thing happened. Basically the PHP plugin in Eclipse wasn't developed any further anymore. So at that time I was looking, well, what am I going to do? NetBeans. PHP Storm was around as well. But NetBeans and PHP Storm both had a problem that they did not have one function that Eclipse had. And that was when my customer calls me, I have a problem on my website. I can just click on FTP and make a connection into the website. In NetBeans and PHP Storm at the time, you have to make a new project, and then you can add the FTP details and then you can connect. Luckily for me, PHP Storm changed that and had the option to just connect to an FTP server as soon as you want to. The biggest problem was switching to PHP Storm, because I was so used to my Eclipse environment, I knew everything there. But then in one project, there were quite a few developers using PHP Storm. I'm like, okay, I'm doing this project with you guys for 1 month, so for 1 month I'll only use PHP Storm. That was 4 or 5 years ago. That month is still going, because I never went back. And especially now, because PHP Storm has a lot of Joomla support, and that's one of the things I'll be sharing with you today. Why I really like PHP Storm today, because it understands how Joomla works. And PHP Storm is really a Swiss pocket knife. It can do a lot of things for a developer, but for a designer as well. It has a lot of tools in there, and I think if I use maybe 1-2% of what the whole package can do, it might be a lot. But it's enough for me. It makes my life easier, so I'm happy with that. The functions that we're going to talk about are first and foremost Joomla support, because, well, it's a Joomla conference, so why not? The deployment feature that PHP Storm uses, Git, how you can start an SSH session from within PHP Storm, scopes, and the debugger. And in this case, it will be Xdebug. First of all, Joomla love. It happened at J and Beyond in Prague, welcome, that I arranged for the, at that time, the product manager of JetBrains to come to the conference, and we would meet up and talk about what JetBrains can do for Joomla and how Joomla can help JetBrains support Joomla. And ever since, I've been in contact with the people at JetBrains, and we've implemented a bunch of features to make PHP Storm understand Joomla, because the people at JetBrains wanted to support Joomla, but they have no clue how Joomla works. So I kind of acted as the liaison, welcome, to tell them, okay, we want this feature supported, and this is where you have to look, and this is what you have to do. And then they can just form that into however PHP Storm works on the inside. The first way people get to notice any Joomla integration in PHP Storm, if they start a new project. You know, a couple years ago, or if you install an older version of PHP Storm, you will find Composer project, Drupal module, and a WordPress plugin, and Joomla wasn't there, which I thought was a real pity. A couple years forward, we now have Joomla integration with the correct logo, because the first release they did of PHP Storm with Joomla support, it just had a globe, I'm like, that's not the correct logo for Joomla, actually. So now we have the correct logo. And at first, the only project type they had was a Joomla component. But as we all know, Joomla has different kind of extensions. We have components, modules, plugins, templates. And now the current version of PHP Storm, you can see they offer every type of extension. And what is behind there is actually in the Joomla repository in GitHub, we have the boilerplates. For those who do not know what a boilerplate is basically a piece of code that is ready made to go. And what PHP Storm will do when you choose one of these extensions, it will download the code from GitHub and you can start your project that way. So you don't have to write the controller and the model and the view all by hand to start. It's basically a very, very simple component builder. What? No? Oh. But now for me, it was that I don't have to build the whole structure again. And that's what I like about this, just to get me started. The other thing that is included in PHP Storm is the code style. I would almost say, unfortunately, Joomla doesn't follow the global code style. We have our own. But you can easily go to the settings of PHP Storm and choose the predefined style for Joomla, and it will set everything. The latest fix they did on this code style, thank God, they added a doc block support. That if the doc blocks is a little piece of description that tells you what this function is doing, and if it has any parameters, there's a specific set in Joomla where you have to have for the parameters a 3 spaces, 2 spaces, 2 spaces. Before, if you would reformat the whole file according to the code style, it would be 1, 1, 1. Well, if you submit a pull request, you get to say, well, your doc block is broken. But now this also sets that to the correct setting everywhere. So now we can reformat the whole file.
Does that cover only the PHP code style or also JavaScript?
Only PHP code style. And I'm glad you brought that up. I have an issue outstanding that they're working on at JetBrains to also include the predefined style for JavaScript. And I found actually on the developer page of Joomla, we have a lot of different code styles. Yeah, exactly, and everything. But I've only seen in PHP Storm, they have the predefined style only available for JavaScript and PHP. But we'll have to see what we can do with the XML and everything else after that. The other way that PHP Storm makes our life easier is with what I like to call the smart classes. So I have used here both the Joomla 3 and the namespace, the name of the functions, JText, which is now text, and JHTML, which is now HTML helper, and next to the database, but I'll get to that after that. So with the text and the HTML helper, I'm going to give a short demonstration just to show you what PHP Storm will do with that for us. Yay, hooray for Joomla.
New computer.
5 months old. Well, there she was, 4 months. Now I can't see the screen. That's not so nice. What are we going to do? You cannot duplicate this, or can I start another PHP Storm? Yeah, I don't think so. No, screen is too far for me. Because I cannot unplug it, right?
Yeah.
I can?
Yes.
Okay. So then well, I unplug it, but then we don't have the screen there.
Yeah.
No. Okay. That's a pity. Let's see what we can do about this. Oh, that's right. Yeah. Duplicate monitor. Thank you.
Yes.
Where is it? Arrangement. Yes, mirror. Yeah, for the presenter notes, it needs to be not mirrored. And for this, it's okay. Okay. Thank you. There we go. We can do presenter mode. Yeah. So now what we all can see is that on line 24 you have the JHTML. This is Joomla 3, so even in Joomla 4 not everything is rewritten yet. But the one thing that was a real bother in the old days, if you wanted to know, I'm gonna take another example because the example we have here only has no arguments. Script. So I know I need to specify something behind here, but I don't always remember in which order they need something. So what I had to do was I could click on this because the underscore is an actual function and that every editor knows. But then I need to decode this code to find out where it's actually going, which file is that function. So what PHPStorm can do, you go on the word script and you control click or control B or command B depending on Mac or Windows, it will jump straight to the function where it is. So I can see immediately which arguments are required. Now for this one it's pretty simple, but if we take the control B or command B or control click if you use the mouse. So if you have a generic list which is just a simple drop down, it also has a bunch of names. It needs to know which options, which name, the key value pair if you use a different one. So also with control B or click you can jump straight there. That has made life so much easier because I don't have to go through the underscore or bookmark files and look around. It jumps directly there. Now we also have JText, or text as it is nowadays. Let's take a language string I know definitely exists. With PHPStorm you can click on the language string and it will tell you all the language files where it's defined. So in this case let's take English and it will jump straight to the location where that key is defined, which I find useful as well. Especially if you're doing multiple language files, like in my case I do English and Dutch, then it's easy to jump around. Also because I'm not sure, is George in the room? No. Because there was talk about, because we have different language files as well. You have the .ini, you have the .sys.ini. They're in the front end, they're in the back end, they're in the plugin folder, they're in the component folder. So you're not always sure where to find that string. And PHPStorm will jump straight there.
But what will they do if we change the rules where to find the stuff?
Sorry, what will they do?
They have to know the rules where we, which files we process in which order, where we look first. Yeah? Do we look first in the component folder or in the
component folder? PHPStorm doesn't look at that. PHPStorm just looks where is the string defined. Because they have the complete index of the files and the strings.
It offers you all of them.
It offers you all of them. Because I have the JS in here. Is there another one? There's another one down here. And then one is the front end file and the other one is the back end file. Now with the screen this big you can't see, but usually at the top you have the path to the file. So that will tell you if you're front end or back end. That's the other thing I like. The only thing that's really missing is we have our configuration files or form fields where you have label and description, which is a language string as well in the XML files. If you do click there, so you don't go anywhere. I spoke with the developer from JetBrains and they're planning to release that in the 2019.3, so which is the next feature release that should come. And then we have basically the language strings in most places, so in the PHP files and in the XML files. Yeah, that should be pretty much everything. And those were the JHTML/HTML helper and the text one. The next one is the database. And I just realized I completely forgot one step at the start because my environment is always set up. If you go to the settings of PHP Storm, you'll have a PHP frameworks where you can tick the box for Joomla integration. It's actually like this. If you open a project and PHP Storm sees if you are in a Joomla project, it will ask you if you want to enable Joomla support or not. Let's see if it will do that if I just turn this off. Yeah, exit. Does it tell me anything, or this project is already indexed so it knows? But anyway, if it tells you if you want to enable Joomla support and you click yes, you will get a pop-up with this question, where is the Joomla installation path? And the path to jconfig, which is basically the configuration PHP file. I've asked them already many times to change the word to jconfig to configuration file. But okay, if you do that and you say okay, then another pop-up comes. If you want to set the setup to Joomla doc blocks, just click set and that will do the code style setting. Now, if you want to connect to your database, PHP Storm has a tab for database. Does anybody use the database in PHP Storm? So if you start your new project, you have set up your whole Joomla site, you loaded the site in PHP Storm, then you still need to set up the database credentials. Well, you actually don't have to, because your credentials are in the configuration PHP file, and PHP Storm can read that file. So all you need to do is, it's a bit small maybe, but you can click the plus here. It's need indexing finished. Needs to finish indexing first. But there's the last option called import from sources. Are we getting there now? Yes. So you click import from sources. And what it will do, it will come up with a screen and all your database credentials already filled in. You don't have to do anything until recently. It's a new bug. I don't know if it's my database or if it's PHP Storm. I haven't figured out yet. I need to set the server time zone. Otherwise, it cannot connect. And you have to put, or we just put our CET, the Central European Time Zone. I'm going to report a bug for that because it's kind of stupid because it took me a while to figure out what to put in there. But okay, that has nothing to do with the Joomla support itself. The URL. Oh, you can just, with the advanced, you can just server time zone put in CET. Yes. Because it's not really a Joomla thing, because if you do it with any other database, the same error comes. Okay, but then it automatically fills everything. You click OK. And then it starts connecting to your database, inspecting it. And then you see you have your whole database there. And you don't even have to retype the password or look what the database name is. It's perfect. Makes life easier. Now the next step is Joomla knows what your database is. Joomla knows your, PHP Storm knows your database. PHP Storm also knows your database prefix that we use in Joomla. So if we start a new... Yes, I will. Thank you. Forgot about that. Yes. So we start a new database connection. From, no, let's quote name everything. No suggestions. So I don't know if you can see in the pop-up, but I type ID, and because I already said I want it from the table content, it shows me that it's the JoomlaDB, so that's the name of my database, and the table is my prefix underscore content. If I do it the other way around, I don't have the content, and he doesn't know yet. You get all the tables where the ID column is used. Now, for ID, that's not very useful, but maybe username is in less tables. That's the only bug they still have to fix also at PHP Store. Is if you hit enter, it replaces the prefix with a real prefix. But apparently it's a bit difficult to sort that out. But okay, so we want username from users. If I want to see more about the user table, I can just Ctrl B or Ctrl click or Ctrl B, and it will jump to the table in the database that we just created. And the same goes for the field name. So which also makes life a little easier if you want to see how your database structure is. No, just with the query builder. Yes. Ah, yes. The question was if you can also use this for the for JTable, and it only works with the query builder. So with command enter, I can actually execute the query as well. In this case, I don't have any SQL session open yet, or and just say new session. And at the bottom, it will open up. And you see the query is executed there, which is very nice. We have one change in Joomla 4. Where we're moving to prepared statements. Thank you. And what will happen then is if you do that, let's see if I can trigger that here. No, there's no bind here. Okay. So with a prepared statement, PHP Storm will show a pop-up which values you want to use for all the prepared statements. So you can type in manually which values you want to use to complete the query, which I think is also kind of nice. Any questions so far? It's a lot of jumping, but that makes really life easier. Now I have to do this one again. And there we go. Huh. Technology is nice when it works. So these are the smart classes, smart stuff in PHP Storm that makes my life the easiest of all. Now, another function, not specifically Joomla related, that I use is the deployment feature in PHP Storm. And deployment allows you to upload a file to an external server or another site on your own machine. Why do I use that? Because I have a project with just my Joomla component, not with the complete Joomla installation. And when I change a file, I want it automatically uploaded to the site, so when I go to the site and it's refreshed, then I can see my changes. The other reason I use it, I have for one of my extensions, it must be an online server because it's for payment gateways, and the payment provider requires a site that is reachable through the internet. And with the deployment features, you can configure one or more servers to upload. And I'll show that in a minute as well. And straight from here, you can also click Browse Remote Host, and then PHP Storm will log you into the server. Now, yeah, and you can just browse the file system like your local file system. One thing that they changed, but that's still good to check. If I go back one screen, you see there the just above the browse remote host, you have the options. What happened in the older versions of PHP Storm, if you upload a file, it just says file uploaded. You don't know where to. But because you need to type the server path and sometimes it's wrong, you can set in the options to have a detailed operation logging. And then it says, I took the file from this place, the full path on your computer, to the full path on your server. So you can see if you're actually in the correct folder. So you can set the deployment options to be automatic. So when you type something and you're done, PHP Storm will automatically save and then automatically upload. There's one downside to that, which I will come to later. You can also turn off automatic and just say upload to remote server. If you have only one remote server, it automatically uploads after invoking that command. If you have more servers, PHP Storm will ask, where do you want to send it to? And it's a good question, because I want to make sure if it's on my live site or if it's on my new site that I'm testing on. There's actually a new feature recently in PHP Storm that allows you to upload to multiple servers at the same time. So if you change one file, it can send it to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10 different servers at the same time, which is actually also pretty cool. And now I'll show you how that works. Ooh. That's something else. Exit presentation mode for a moment. Or can we see that anyway? So with tools you have deployment, and with configuration you can set up all your servers here. It can be an FTP, FTPS, SFTP, a local. I still don't know after all these years what the difference is with a local or an in-place. They seem to do the same thing for me. SFTP, JDDE. And now I'm going to show, which is actually a pretty cool feature. If you work with SSH servers, usually on your system you have a config file where you have all the settings for those servers and you just have to type SSH domain name and you can connect. You can actually do the same in PHP Storm. Where you can choose the OpenSSH config and authentication agent. Wrong one. Let's try this. Yes, I want to connect. And then connect it successfully. I don't have to put in any key pass or any password file anymore, or a password itself. It will just take all the settings from your current SSH setup. And when you create a deployment server, you have to set up the mapping, because PHP Storm needs to know from locally where do I need to put it on the server. So the local path is automatically filled from your project, and the deployment path, you can click on the folder and then it goes to, in this case, your remote server. Oh, not sure if that should work. No, cancel. If you want to have multiple mappings, you can add a new mapping and then you get automatically a list. So you want to say, I want this folder to go there, this folder to go there. I use this a lot for my payment component because I'm supporting 20 different other people's extensions and they're all in different places. So I cannot say, if you take the route from my website, it's always here, always there. So per folder, I can specify where on the server it needs to put the files. But for now, we can do with one. If you have the server configured, you'll see that the deployment is clickable. And you can choose if you want to upload there, or you want to download something from there, or compare files, or even sync. And we can say upload. And you'll see, because the detailed logging is on, it tells me the complete path for my local file to where it has gone on my server. So I like to see the complete logging, because if there's anything not working, I can check if the file is actually in the correct place. Because I spent too much time in the past looking in the wrong place. And so once you have set up one of those servers, you can actually click the automatic upload. And in this case, it doesn't ask me anything because I only have one server. And if I make any change now to this file, for example, we delete this. How do I get there? File transfer. You see, it has copied the file again, and I haven't done anything. Now to the downside of this. At some point, I do this with a lot of my sites. They're all on servers. Luckily, I also use Git for all my sites through GitHub. What I've done in one place, apparently, without knowing, I hit the delete button on a folder. Automatic upload works great. Then you log into the server and do a git status and you see deleted files and you're like, why? Luckily with Git you can just check them out and you're back to where you were. But that's one thing to keep in mind, that automatic upload also deletes if you delete locally.
Roland?
Yes?
Can you manually delete files locally? Which you deleted locally and push this to the server? The delete command?
I'm not sure I understand the question, because if
you
I
want to do this on the server.
Then if automatic upload is on, PHP will Storm will automatically delete the file on the server as well.
Yeah, automatic upload.
I'm not sure if it's going to do it then. I actually never tried, I don't think so. Yeah, the one of the other things, indeed, the folder sync is also very nice because you have a visual diff between the two local or between the two locations. Elisa, you have a question.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
It will be uploaded. But I have a template which is on GitHub.
Yeah.
And I use it in a project.
Mm-hmm.
Symlink. So the Symlink folder is not recognized from PHP Strong. External change.
Ooh, I wonder if it even can detect changes on a Symlink. Okay.
Yeah, but you can, go around that by using hard links in folders for files, but that's probably beyond this topic.
But if it used to work in PHP Storm, it sounds more like a bug.
Yeah.
Then we should report it. Because I actually don't use symlinks myself, except for other repositories that are, well, but then they're submodules again, so it's a little bit different. So the other thing you can do that was on the list is connect to your server through PHP Storm. We've set up an SSH connection to our server and we've uploaded the file. Now with tools, you have the option here, start SSH session. If you click that, you'll get a pop-up to add credentials, or you can select an existing server. You hit enter and you're logged into your server. And we can find that file that we just uploaded, because it's here in the folder. Is it read? I'm not sure if it's readable, but this says components, and it uploaded it there. Ooh. So it's really a shortcut to go to straight to your server from within your project. Sorry. Yes. He says PHP Storm also has a remote host browser. It's actually on the site, but because the screen is so big, we can't see it. And if you have multiple hosts configured, the dropdown will show them all. Well, we only have one now. And here you also logged into the server. Peter.
So you can browse. Can you also edit?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's see if I can get there, because I'm actually in the permission denied. Let's see, /home:\d. Okay. So we have the web apps, Roland D, and then there was components. It says the file is identical to the remote one. The file has been modified. Do you want to upload? Then you have an upload button. And it uploads it back to the server.
You always work locally, not directly on the remote.
I usually always work locally.
No, this feature first fetches a local copy, which is pushed back. It doesn't edit directly on the remote server.
No, it's more an in-memory thing. But yeah, you have to press save somewhere, basically. And the upload button is basically your save function. Is it here? No. We can refer this. Yes, it's all fine. And the browse remote host, that is basically the feature I was talking about at the beginning. This allows me to just enter any FTP details. And I can connect straight to the server. I don't have to create a whole new project and then start browsing. I have to change the screen. Yeah, we've done this as well, the SSH connection. So you'll see in this example, we have two servers. You can select which one you want to connect to or enter details. This is also reachable through a shortcut, which is Ctrl-Alt-Shift-X or Command-Alt-Shift-X. You learn how to wiggle your fingers a lot with all the shortcuts in PHP Storm. So the other thing is navigation. For the people here, I'm a keyboard person. I got an operation on my wrist. I'm not sure if it's because of the mouse or because of something else. But since then, I had to use the mouse on the left hand because I wasn't allowed to use this for 3 months. But regardless of that, I try to do everything with the keyboard because my hands are there. I don't have to go to a mouse. I like the keyboard. Luckily for me, PHP Storm has a lot of shortcuts. And you can configure even more if you want to, because it's all configurable. The one thing they changed in one of the recent versions of PHP Storm is you can open or find everything by just hitting Shift twice. And I'll show that again. So if you hit Shift twice, you get this pop-up. And you see it has several tabs, all classes, sorry, files, symbols, actions. And with the all, you can find your files. The one thing I use it for, now in Joomla, we have the J layouts. And the J layouts are like joomla.pagination.item, I think. And all I need to do is turn it into forward slashes because it's basically a path. That's one thing to find the files really fast. But you can also click on actions. You've seen I did this with the presenter mode. The one thing I use is also for, because of the formatting, two tabs. And then it will change. You don't actually have to write a space either. It will find it regardless, which is also kind of nice. The other shortcut I use a lot is Command E or Control E. That's your recent file list. So these are the files you've recently opened or done something with. Almost every list in PHP Storm, you can just start typing. And it will filter it. It's doing that with the file list. I need a class. You have here the structure of the whole file. You can start typing there. It will filter. It will do that pretty much everywhere. If you want to not use 2x shift to get to the alt tab, but straight to the actions, you can do a command shift A and it will be on the actions tab. So you can find your action immediately. One of the other things could be like if you want to reformat the code to the Joomla code style. Now format the 31 lines, rearrange code. The screen. So that's the quick switching. There's a lot more features that are available in PHP Storm. One of them is the scopes, where you can say, I only want to show files from these selected directories. So when you're working on a component that is inside a Joomla installation, you don't need the whole Joomla tree. You only want your front end or your back end, so you can just create a scope and say, I only want to see these files. And then select the scope. And PHP Storm will only show those files in the file tree. There's a dropdown at the top where you can still select all the project files. And you can still see all the files. So this also helps with sort of being focused on your own code. Apart from what I've said here, there's like a million other options. What I said, this is really for me as a developer. There's a lot of options for designers. What Elise was saying, the compiling of the CSS files. I never write any CSS code, so I never use that feature, but I know it's there and I know it's used a lot. If you need anything in PHP Storm, it's usually just trying to find out where is it? Not even if it exists, but where is it? Because PHP Storm has so much on board.
Yes, and if it doesn't exist, try and find a plugin for it.
Yes, there's a lot of plugins as well that can do or add multiple functionality. For example, the Git flow for those who use it. And if you have any more questions, as I said, just come and find me outside here or on Glip or on GitHub or anywhere. And I'll be happy to answer any questions. Any questions now?
Could you give us a short impression of the comparison view? You said there is a view to compare folders and files.
Yeah.
My favorite is Beyond Compare.
I'm not sure if it can meet up with Beyond Compare. Let's see. I need my no, that's the wrong one. Haha. Control. Let's see. Exit. Yeah, that's true. Let's see. Version control. You can actually do this. Where is it? Git. Compare with. This is only the file view. If you compare, I don't know if this can go into presentation mode. So this is a comparison between two files, and it will tell you whether the changes from left need to go to right or what has changed. And the folders is basically the same, Richard. Yeah, you just have the folders and then you can click on the file and then you can do the diff. I can show you more outside because we're out of time here. Thank you for coming.
Maybe one short question. They don't do this because they love Joomla. I think they want to make money. So
yes. It's not out of the goodness of their hearts.
So the question is there a free version with limited functionality and how much is...
No, there's no free version. Joomla has licenses for people who work on the Bug Squad.
No, not necessarily on the Bug Squad.
Ah, not anymore?
People that contribute, that's not necessarily...
Yeah, and Niels Bracek...
Not
anymore? Oh. He is managing it. Nobody told me. But I think a personal license is €49, around that price. For students it's free, but
students and community members, so if you contribute to an open source project, no.
No, they need some validation, otherwise everybody yells I'm contributing to Joomla.
Because this was my first license.
No, you can get a license if you show them that you have a community project and then you qualify for that. Joomla qualifies for that. I have a pool of licenses. If you can show to me that you are structurally contributing.
No.